again, but then again, it's a win-win-win again. So genuine, oh so genuine. Pop, pop, pop like a firecracker. Crack that back like a chiropractor. I got berserk on a daily basis. Y'all recognize me, I'm melting faces. B-C-R-K, gonna get your heart rate up to the sky, up to the sky, up to the sky.
Hello, race fans, and welcome to the finale here in the Ortho Cup Series Season 2 here at Homestead. Our final four is here, and they're all lined up on the inside, starting inside the top 10 here for tonight's race at this gorgeous lit-up racetrack here tonight. And it's been a while, but the final four is finally ready to take on the final track in the final race of Season 2. A lot of things going on next season. So this is the last season with the original Sprint Cup Series cars and teams. Customized teams will be put in place next season. And there's a little thing at the bottom I'm going to explain about here in a second. Right now, you can end in the description below in this video and next videos coming on in the future for the Ortho Cup Series and GMS Productions YouTube channel. You can start... I don't know how to explain it, but it's right here in the description, but start sending me a driver start your engines thing. So if you want to be someone to say driver start your engines or gentleman start your engines, you can send me a video and tell me about it, and so I can go watch it, and you could possibly be a part of Season 3. And I want to try to get fans and more people interacted into this YouTube channel so that more people can be more attracted in to it. So let's get off to our starting lineup here, as on the pole is Julian Quintero in the number 47, competing for a championship alongside Matt Dalio. Then you have the one car of Aaron Wolpel Jr. alongside John Andrews. Then you have Riley Smith here in the 24, competing for a championship alongside Tristan Allen. And then you got Cole Baker, your farthest back title contender, starting seventh alongside Ryan Madden. And I'm just going to scroll through the field here. I'm not going to mention the other ones, but today is a very big day. If you win this race, it's good and all, but you don't get as much attention as the people who are battling for the championship, and also some people who are battling for another championship. The 62 here we're coming up on is battling with Garrett Sidnor, Cameron Black, Garrett Sidnor, and I believe Marty Johnson. They're all competing for that part-time championship, and that is going to be very crucial here today. And so we're going to get to the race here. And like I said earlier, if you want to be a part of Season 3, you can make a video of you saying, driver, start your engines. And you could be saying, driver, start your engines in a race for Season 3. Now, the Daytona 500 has already been put together and everything. Well, not been recorded, but it has been. The cars are getting are almost done painted and put together, so 27 laps here tonight to round out Season 2, and this is a building season. Season 1 was a startup season, a building season. Let's see how we do in Season 2. Season 2 is more of a get the setups on every track right, and make sure that we, as GMS Productions people, can get Season 3 right. And the green flag is going to be out here for the finale in Season number 2. Julian Quintero takes the green flag here at Homestead. Gets a great jump there on the start. The number one machine right behind him. Aaron Wolpel Jr. won the championship last season. He could be the only championship here, or champion here in this series, for two seasons if he can win back-to-back titles here tonight. He's right on the bumper of Julian Quintero heading into turn three. And he's underneath him. The one car trying to take a shot here at the lead on the closing of lap number one. And leading the first lap here tonight is, I really don't know, and we're about to see the ticker here in a second, and it was Aaron Wolpel Jr. just by a little bit. All four title contenders here in the top five. Quintero trying to battle back on the high side. He is trying to keep his title hopes alive in this final four. All four final four guys are in the top five, now about to be all in the top four right here, as Aaron Wolpel Jr. looks like he's going to take away the lead, but here are three title contenders battling for second. This is a heated battle here, and it's going fast, and Quintero needs to get down to the bottom or find a better groove on this racetrack, because being up on the high side is not good for a long time, but it is good to hold it if you're trying to protect your lead on the last lap for a win. And now that's at 47 is going to drop back to fourth place. And looks like he is going to be now stuck on the high side. Aaron Wobble Jr. is the leader. Cole Baker here trying to get around Riley Smith for second. Quintero continuing to fall back as two front row guys are battling side by side with him for position. They're all battling for that designated fourth position. Quintero is still trying to keep his car in this top four. And all four title contenders are running real well here early. And a bunch of guys scraping the wall in the back of the field. I think Quintero might actually tap the wall there coming out of turn two. He's under attack from Matt Dalio. He runs good in the NR 2003 series here on YouTube. He's looking to get his first GMS Productions win. And looks like, ooh, contact there between the 35 and the 38. They get together, and that's going to allow the 38 to get a great run off that of turn two. And that's also going to allow the 47 of Julian Quintero to try to keep his distance. And now we got a battle for the lead. This is what I really should be paying attention to, but the 47's just been battling for position on the racetrack as Julian Quintero continues to fall. Cole Baker takes the lead for the first time in this race, and Riley Smith is trying to be the next title contender to pounce. Julian Quintero, he's just trying to get off that high line as look who is coming here in the 83, Nicholas Samadio on the inside line with the help from Reagan Whitlock in the 46. Along with Ryan Madden here, who has won a lot of races this season, in running ninth in the field right now. Cole Baker remains your race leader. Riley Smith is second. Tristan Allen making contact with the wall in the front straightaway, mid-pack. Or more like in the back, or the top 15. The top two have kind of trying to break away from the rest of the field. But Aaron Walpole Jr. is not going to allow that. He wants a chance at this title once again, and the 47 has dropped back in line, but that cost him a bit of spots, and now he's backed up to sixth place. The one car now under attack for third, and the 24 is attacking the 31 for the race lead. And we're going to get another camera angle here, and I'm going through the back of the field. Nobody has caused a wreck yet, and we're about to have an intense battle here for third. As look at this battle, the one car, the 47, they're right in the middle of it, but the leaders are side by side, the 31 on the high side, Cole Baker trying to get that run, they're four wide for third place, Julian Quintero all the way down on the bottom, and Aaron Wobble Jr. just hit the wall, and that might be a problem for the one team, they are dropping back in that one machine, and they're finally going to get a break here in some cars, but that might have pushed them back outside the top 10. Julian Quintero under attack for the fourth position. Cole Baker losing contact with Riley Smith for position. The 24 machine took away the race lead. All four title contenders have been in the race lead at some point in this race already tonight. And I think the one car is still hitting that wall. Yes, he is. And he has dropped back in line now, but he's all the way backed up to 12th. Julian Quintero is actually coming through the field quite nicely. And my bad there on the camera angles. There we go. Getting back to the main one. Julian Quintero has actually fought his way back up into the top five. And the 31 gets contact from the 38 of John Andrews. That pushes the 31 up the racetrack. And that's going to allow Riley Smith to pull away a bit more with his race lead. Now, Riley Smith knows how to win a championship. In the Brooks Elimination Series that was held here on GMS Productions, he won both championships. He's looking for his third GMS Productions championship. The only two drivers that have won championships here on GMS Productions have been Riley Smith and Aaron Wobble Jr., who are both in the final four. Cole Baker and Julian Quintero, they're the two dark horses, but they've been running really impressive in this race so far as they are second and third. Look at the 18 of Stuart Grattan making his way up into the top five. He's going three wide for that fourth position. Reagan Whitlock in the middle, pushing the 31 of Cole Baker. Little contact with a wall possibly there for the 38 of John Andrews. Aaron Walpole Jr. needs a bit of help here to get back up into contention, running 11th. He's going to need to get by a lot of cars here. The top three in the field are still title contenders, but Julian Quintero has finally re-caught back up to the race leader and is finally competing again for the championship lead and possibly the championship right here. The 47 underneath the 24 for the top spot. Cole Baker went high going up into that turn. And Julian Quintero looking to take away the race lead and the championship lead. If he wins the race tonight, that would be a huge break for this team. Because the 47 and the 31, they're both dark horses for one reason. They got into the chase on points. Points alone. Riley Smith and Aaron Wobble Jr. got into the chase on a win. And Aaron Wobble Jr., we're going to go look back at him as he continues to drop back. He's in a terrifying situation going 3 wide for 11th. And he's on the worst lane possible right now, the high side. Any other title contenders in trouble? Nope, the top 3 are now. All of the top 3 are championship contenders. We just passed halfway. The 24, Riley Smith, is the race leader as he took the race lead back from Julian Quintero. Quintero now battling back on the high side as Aaron Walpole Jr. scrapes the wall and he continues to fall back. It's going to be a hard night for Aaron Walpole Jr. if he can't get back to the front. He could possibly miss out on getting 2 championships in a row here in the Ortho Cup Series. So we could possibly have a new champion in this series tonight. And the 27 hit the wall hard in the back of the field. That was Dan Park. Big contact for the 27. I thought that was going to bring out a caution. We have not had a caution yet in this race. Let's look on our part-time drivers. There's the 62 and the 25. They're all battling. They're doing the same thing as the Final Four is doing. They're battling for a championship in the part-time division. The 40 car has it. The 25 and the 62 are chasing him down. And there goes a 17 of Jesse Turner into the wall. We're going to go back up to the front of the field. And where was Aaron Walpole Jr.? I think he's continuing to fall back. Yes, he is. That one car has fallen outside the top 20 now. And he's been scraping that wall every time we come by. And Riley Smith, according to the ticker, was the leader last time by. But Quintero has a run going through 3 and 4. Quintero to the inside. And they're probably going to be dead even here at the stripe. The 47 looks like... He looks like he got it that time by, did he? No, Riley Smith took the kept the lead barely that time by. Cole Baker in a little bit of a situation, dropped back to 4th there on that last lap. Or actually, he was scored 5th. And it looks like the 83, Nicholas Samadio, trying to spoil the party. Not won a race yet this season. I think he was real close at Talladega. It's been a while since I've posted a race, so I've a little bit lost on memory. David Johnson won that race barely over the 83 and the 34 machine. And tonight, the 83 trying to compete for the win, as that is what he's just going for, trying to build up possibly momentum for next season, as he does not have a secured ride for next season. So, a tough break for that. The 24, I believe they don't have... I don't know if they have a race team set up for next season, but they don't not... I don't think they have a ride. Neither does Quintero, Baker, or Aaron Walpole Jr. None of those guys have secured rides next season, but they're all battling for a championship. The 31's now in trouble, slipping back here on the outside. Nicholas Samadio has been giving him a hard time. And it looks like it'll be these two really battling for the championship if the 31 gets in trouble here. Getting pushed up to the high side here in a almost four wide situation. The 31 losing ground on the 24 and the 47, battling side by side for the race lead. This has been a very fun race to watch. As we do lose a championship contender after another, after this green flag run as they get shuffled back on the outside. But the 24, Riley Smith, really wants a championship. The 47 was so glad they made it into the chase in the first place. Them being able to lead laps, move their way through the rounds has been a huge accomplishment for the 47 team. But here comes Nicholas Samadio. He could be an obstruction for that 47 team if the 83 does get by for that position. And a caution that comes out right now could end the race. So we have to be careful with that as well. And the 31, he has fallen back a while. He fell back a ways. He's 13th. I think the 31 is out as well for the championship. I think it's going to be down to the 47 and the 24. Two guys who have been battling all season long to keep they were mainly consistent this season. To make your win useful in this chase, you had... I mean, to get into the chase initially, you had to have a win and be in the top 30 in points. The 47 team, they made it in on points. The 24 team made it in on a win and consistency. And the 83 of Nicholas Samadio is going to go to the inside of the 24 Riley Smith and miss his chances up to keep the race lead as he's going to push the 47 or the 24 back. And the 47 might go side by side here with the 24 for position. For the championship, as we have 4 laps to go in this championship race. Riley Smith charging back on the inside, trying to take away that race lead, looking for his second win of the season. And coming up through this season, he won the All-Star race in Season 1, and that was all he did, and made it, didn't even make it past the first round of the chase, but this season he's in the Final Four, and 3 laps to go, he's battling for the lead and the championship. The 47... Last season, that ride was driven by Carson Scott, I believe. this season. Julian Quintero has put the heart and mind into that team, trying to get them the best effort that he can, or trying to get them the best finishes he can, and he's been doing that. Coming here to two laps to go, can Riley Smith hold off the field? And most importantly, Julian Quintero, because the 31, you see him scraping the outside wall. He continues to fall back. The 47's getting a run through turns 1 and 2 here. He's going to get to the inside of the 24 coming out of turn 2. Down the back straightaway. They are side by side going into the turn 3. Who's going to have it here coming out of 4? The 24 is starting to slip back. Can the 47 keep his lead, or will the 46 mess up the 47's chances for the championship? White flag in the air. And they're wrecking a little bit in the back. The 47 going to hold on to the race lead. Riley Smith trying to get around the 46. Quintero is having an excellent view out in front of him. Half a lap to go down the back straightaway. Riley Smith being blocked by Reagan Whitlock for second. He's being pushed back on the outside. Julian Quintero coming out of turn 4. He's going to do it. The underdog coming into the championship 4 wins the championship. Julian Quintero takes home his first win of the season. And he takes the championship. Riley Smith was 2 positions short and 1 lap short of taking that championship home. And the 31 team, they finished 24th. And the one car, they finished 32nd. So those 2 championship contenders fell back a bit on that run. But wow. The 47 team, what an accomplishment. They must be, like, excited. The 47 is going to come down to pit road for inspections here, but he's going to do a burnout here in a second, showing his appreciation to his team and showing how much this victory is a very big step for them, for this 47 team, as their 47 team is going to give up their rights to, I can't remember the race team, but the 47 will be here next season in a Chevrolet for sponsored by Kroger. But wow. How about that win by the 47 and the championship? Got 2-for-1 right there. That was a fun race to watch, and I hope you guys enjoyed it because that was really fun to watch. The 47 was the underdog coming into the season. I had no favorites really coming into the season. I knew Aaron Walpole Jr. knew how to get the championship done, but no other championship 4 contenders were really competing with him this season. Jesse Turner and Riley Smith have really been battling hard to put themselves in championship contention. Riley Smith came so close. He would have been the first driver to get more than 2 championships in 2 different series. So he would have had a total of 3 if he had won it tonight. But no, he didn't. Julian Quintero takes the championship. Not only does he take the championship, but Chevrolet will get the championship 2 years in a row. Chip Ganassi got it last year. This year it's going to be JTG Daugherty Racing going to get their championship for the 47 team. And all 4 championship contenders were Chevrolet. So in last season, also representatives into the finale were different manufacturers. And Chevrolet still ended up winning it. But here tonight, Chevrolet comes out on top for the championship. They already knew that coming in this race, but Julian Quintero was the underdog of the 4 that came out to win this championship, and he did what he needed to do, and he'll be doing burnouts here in a second to celebrate his win and his championship. Congratulations to him one more time for his championship and his accomplishments this season, and thank you guys for watching this season. It's been a rough one, a rough 9 months, but we finally got to the finish of this series this season. And hopefully that this mic was better, because this is a new mic and everything. But anyway, like I said at the beginning of the video, if you want to be a part of Season 3, you can take a video of yourself saying, "Gentlemen, start your engines." And I will make sure that that will be included to the pre-race ceremony stuff next season. So thank you guys for watching once again, and here is Julian Quintero's celebration. Bye-bye, and see you for Season 3.
Red Bull in my hands, feels like I got wings. Lot of people in my face, but I can't hear a thing. It's like my head's up in the clouds, head's up in the clouds, and I ain't coming down, no. Just turn the music on, just let me get lost. I swear that I'ma lose it if somebody turns it off. What are you, out your mind? You must be out your mind. Just turn the music off, turn the music off. So motivated, like Nikes on my feet. Understand the situation. Yeah, this is not a game. This is not a game. You ain't gonna bring me down. Yeah, I mean what I say.